So, in the series of learning programming in C, we are discussing strings in C. We have discussed what basics about string, like what is a string, how to declare a string, how to initialize a string at compile time, that we have discussed in previous video, and some important point about strings also. So, one question for you is before starting this video, one question is, you have to tell me in comment box, is a string a data type in C, yes or no? You have to tell me in comment box, right? Now, let's start with the next part in strings in C. In this video, we'll see how to initialize a string at runtime, or you can say how to read a string. So, you can read or you can initialize a string at runtime using a standard function. What is that function? Scanf as well as getS. Two functions are there. Scanf and getS. Getcar is also there, but obviously getcar can also read only one character, so we have to put in, that into loop. Right, so we'll discuss these two, to read a string at runtime or to initialize a string at runtime. We'll discuss the drawbacks of both the function as well as some advantages of using both the functions. Right, first we will discuss how to read a string using scanf function. Right, string is what? It's nothing but a character array which is ending with null character. Right, see, I hope the difference is clear between character array and string. If I declare something like this, a string like char, string name is s1 I am taking, right? And here the size is 10, right? And here I am going to store Jenny. This is how we can initialize a string at compile time using a string literal. Whatever you are writing in double quotes, that is considered as a string. Automatically compiler will do what? How to store this? 10 bytes would be allocated here. Right, suppose memory is from 1000 to 1009, and this S1 is the name of the string, and it is containing what? Base address, or you can say the address of the first byte of this character array. This complete is what? Character array. And here I am going to store what? J-E-N-N-Y. This is what? A string. So compiler automatically will append, will put a null character after this string. It means this complete is character array. Here we are having some garbage value, but in this character array, string is what? Only this one. Once compiler will find this null character, means it is end of string. End of string. Right? So this is what string, but yeah, this is character array. So that is difference. String would always be ended with a null character. Otherwise, string is just a character array, or you can say it's an array of character. Right, so I hope you now got the difference between character array or string. You can, if anyone asks, then you can tell with some example. Right, now rather than initializing this string here, I'm going to read this using scanf function. Right, so I'm just writing first of all, like enter string, that should be printed on the console, on the output screen when you run the program. And how to read using scanf? So format specifier for reading a string is %s, right? And simply here you have to pass what? Name of the string, s1. That's it, you can read the string. But now here the difference is, while we were reading array, because obviously string is also array, but it is character array, right? But while we were reading array, then we use for loop for reading array, I hope you remember. And for printing also we were using for loop. But here we are not using any for loop. Although it's an array, it's character array. Here also we are having, suppose if we are entering a string, something like this. See, when you are going to run, then it should print enter string, and suppose I am entering J-E-N-N-Y, Jenny. So here also we are having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 characters. So you have to print 5 characters, right? But we are not using any loop. Another difference is we are not using any address of operator here, right? Why address of operator we are not providing here? Because S1 is what? And it is containing 1000, the base address of this character array, or you can say the first address of this one. So if you have entered Jenny, so Jenny would be stored something like this, J-E-N-N-Y, right? And after completing this, a null character, which shows that here it is ending of the string, and here maybe some garbage value are there. We don't know any garbage value is there, right? So this is character array, this is what? String. So now when you pass S1, means you are passing 1000, that is address of the first one, address of the first byte, the first location. So J would be stored here, right? And E would be automatically stored at the next position, then N, then N, then Y, and then at last, when you press enter, then what it means, and end of the string means when you have entered, when you press enter, it means it will store null character at the end. It will show end of the string here, right? So that is why we are not passing any address of operator, because we are obviously passing the address only by writing this name S1, right? And we are not using any for loop. Why so? Because here we don't need to specify the address for every character you are entering, right? Suppose you are taking an array, int array of size 5 or 10, means you are writing what? Enter 10 elements of an array. We know exactly we have to enter 10 elements. 10 elements in array, 10 integer in this array. So, and we were passing address for individual integers in the array, right? Memory location for all the 10 integers in for loop. But here, if suppose I am asking enter a string or enter name, basically we use a string something like this. I have written S1, but basically we use what? To enter some name or this kind of thing. So, char name 10. So, here I am writing enter name. So, I don't know how many characters are there in a name. It's not like that I'll specify enter 10 characters of your name. No, right? We don't know how many characters we are going to enter, right? So, now this is percentage S. This format specifier has been designed, has been written in such a way that we don't need to put this scanf into for loop, and we don't need to put any like address of operator here. That reason I have already told you, right? Now, here also it will print enter name, right? So now see, okay, now if you want to print this string, then you simply use printf percentage s. Percentage s is what? Format specifier to read and to print a string, right? And s1, or rather than s1, now the name of the string is name I am taking. So here also you will pass name, right? So, what it will print here, J-E-N-N-Y. This is how you can read using scanf function. But now the drawback of this is, if I want to enter the name something like this, if I am entering name here like Jayanti Khatri, Jayanti then space and then Khatri. So, now, what it will store here, and suppose size I am taking, size should be what? Size should be what? Number of character plus 1. Plus 1 is for null character. So, how many characters are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So, for 14 characters including white space plus 1 is for null. It should be 15 at least, or I am taking maximum, that is 30. So, that you can store up to 30 characters, right? So, now, the output should be Jayanti Khatri, but the output you will get only Jayanti if you are using scanf to read this kind of thing. Why? Because scanf will not consider white space in string. So when you enter, then how it would be stored here in this one? Suppose it is up to 30 characters, 30 blocks, means the location would be up to 1029, and 1000 is stored here. So it will store J. When you enter J, it would be stored here. When you press like A, something like this, J, then it would be stored here. A, here, Y, then A, N, T, and I. And now, before writing Khatri, I am providing a space. So when you press space, then it will not consider it, scanf will not consider space in string. So it will think that it is end of the string, and compiler will automatically put here null character. So space Khatri, so it is not going to store this Khatri here. Here it should be some garbage value, and when you will print it, it will only print Jayanti. See, it is not printing any garbage value, because obviously name is what? A character array of 30 characters. So, it should print like Jayanti, and remaining character would be some garbage value. So here it should be some garbage value, but it is not printing garbage value. We want the exact output. Obviously, we want the exact name. We don't want any garbage value. That is why compiler will automatically output this null character at the end of the string. So whenever you read this, when you are printing %s with %s, this format specifier, it is written something like this. It is programmed something like this, right? So whenever it will read till I, then it will read null character. It means end of string. It will not print anything which is beyond this null character, right? So it will only print Jayanti here. So this is what one drawback of scanf. Like if I want to print Jayanti, Khatri, Lamba, and or you can say Jenny's lectures is a, you know, is best channel for CS and IT students. So it will not print the entire line. It will print only the characters until it find a white space. It will store till then. If you write Jayanti and like this Khatri without any white space, it's okay. It will print Jayanti Khatri here, right? But if white space, then it will not store. So that is one drawback of scanf function. I hope you got it. To overcome this drawback, we use getS function. getS will what? Read the complete line including white space until you press a new line, or you can say enter, right? Till then it will read the complete line. So if you want to read the complete line, then use getS function. Yeah, there is one more drawback, that is both for scanf and getS, that we will discuss after discussing getS. So I hope you got now scanf function and its drawback. Now see how getS function would be used. Same, we declare a string, enter name, and here rather than scanf I am using what? getS. And here you just need to pass the name of the string. Here name is what? Name only. So that's it. No format specifier, nothing else. And simply you can print printf using format specifier and name of the string. Also for printing also we use putS. That also we'll discuss in the next video. Both printf and putS, everything about these two things. Now see what should be the output of this thing. Now enter name, and I am entering name like something like this. Jayanti space Khatri space Lamba, right? And now, and after that I am pressing enter, right? So it will store here Jayanti space Khatri space Lamba, and whenever you press enter, it will stop reading and automatically means end of string, and at the last it will put what? Compiler will put null character at the end, right? So when we read, it will print Jayanti space Khatri space Lamba. So that is how you can read an entire line with space and everything using getS function, right? So now it is better than scanf, but drawback is what? See, for both scanf and getS function, what is the drawback? Buffer overflow drawback. Now what is this thing? See here, if I am writing here name and I am providing size 5 only, right? It means 4 character we can store and 1 is for null character, right? So now we are entering a name, and here I am entering same Jayanti space Khatri space Lamba. So it will try to read, it will try to store the entire string. Although space is allocated for only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, only 5 bytes, only for 5 characters. And 1 is obviously for, it should be null. So, you know, according to the logic, whatever we have studied in string, only JAYA should be stored, and last it should be what? A null character, right? But here it will store the entire string. It will try to store entire string and it will print the entire string. You can run this program. So this is what overflow. It is not going to check the buffer size. Now memory is allocated only 5 bytes. So it is going to store beyond this memory here. So whatever is there in this memory, it is going to overwrite that thing. So that is very risky. Maybe some, you know, very important information or some critical program is written this beyond this memory. We don't know. about the computer memory. So that it is going to overwrite. It is going to, it will try to overwrite that program, and it will try to store the entire string till you enter a new line. So that would be very, you know, risky to use. It's not safe. It's very unsafe, right? So that is why it's risky to use getS, right? Because of the buffer overflow condition. Same with scanf. Scanf will also do same thing. If I modify this program something like this, rather than getS, better to use fgets. That also we will discuss in a separate video, right? It is better to use rather, than this getS and scanf. So here I am writing scanf and percentage s, and here I am going to pass only name here, right? And I'm going to print, okay, name. This also will do same thing. Here, I think four characters should it should take, and one is for null, right? And if I write here Jayanti, so the characters are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 characters, and one also one would be null, means 8, right? So yeah, it will try to store complete this name Jayanti, and it will print Jayanti, but only the buffer size is for 5 characters. So it is also having the same problem of buffer overflow. It is not going to check the buffer size while taking input. It is also going to overwrite. It is also going to store this thing and beyond this allocated memory. I hope you are getting my point, right? Is it confusing? No, right? Okay. Now, see, now, okay, in scanf we have one thing, like here if I write percentage 4s, now it means it will only read 4 characters. You are, suppose at the output screen you are entering enter name Jayanti, it will store now only J-A-Y-A, only 4 characters, and after that null character. So this is one alternative. But obviously you have to do some hard coding, like I want to enter only 10 character, 15 character, something like this. That is not a good, I think, practice. So rather than this, we can use fgets function. That we will discuss in a separate video. So I hope you are clear with scanf, getS, the advantages and drawbacks and everything about this thing. You can try your own, right? In the next video, we will see printf and putS to print a string. And then we will see a program on strings, and I'll show you practically on my laptop. So now I'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.